Hey everyone, welcome to another day of the vlog here. Just on the bike right now. So this morning I did about an hour run, then actually ran over to the pool. Ran because it was like minus a billion outside. Swam, did an easy hour recovery swim, and then ran back because again, it was still very cold. Then just recorded a very good podcast this afternoon. All about Zwift, be coming out later this week with Pacing and Racing. Stay tuned. Now I'm on to the bike. So the bike workout for tonight, I mentioned it in one of my other videos last week that I'm undertaking something that I dub Project 400. So what Project 400 is, and I mentioned it on Instagram as well, is that at the moment my peak 5 minute power is around 386 done in a race. I've gone over that, like for 4 minutes, I've gone to about 390 plus. And based on one of the KISS community races on the NYC course, I think that number needs to go up a little bit for me to be really, really competitive in that race. So I kind of arbitrarily picked 400 because it's a good, nice round number and it'll be a very, very high watts per kilogram. So this workout is now the third workout specifically aimed at that number. The last two went very well. Both of them were big successes and hope to build on that here. So this one will be about 75 minutes in length and I'll put the workout description just in the description of this video. In terms of feelings going into it, my only real concern, this is the sixth day in a row where my morning's weight has been less than the previous day's morning weight, and I'd say I'm not actively trying to lose weight right now, and it was a very low number this morning, which is, like I said, a little bit concerning because I'm not actively trying to cut weight right now. Like I said, it's a little weird, and I'm hoping that it doesn't affect this workout. At the moment, it really hasn't had any performance impacts. I haven't noticed them yet. If it continues to drop, I'd say I'll give it a few more days, but if it continues to drop, then I'll have to investigate further into things because maybe just my nutrition, take another look at it and make sure I'm getting the numbers that I need to be getting. But yeah, so we'll check back in. I'll let you know how everything's going.
For at sælge de plader, tør modtage dem, så drop de sladder. Der er mange mennesker, der hader. Det er helt normalt, når man er fra de gader. Nogle gange så kigger jeg op og tænker på, om min far han kigger ned. Han skal vide, at hele familien er i sikkerhed. Så hvil i fred. Holdet var med mig gennem de kolde sletter. Skriver det ned, så går det jo letter. Og du skal vide, der er smæk på at lide i den hurtige bane. Sådan kan det nemt gå. La la la. Vi alle er mennesker, vi alle kan fejle. La la la. Men kan du se dig selv i spejlet?
Jeg husker da jeg stod ved en skillevej, og jeg tænkte, hvem er der virkelig for mig? Føler mig velsignet og snakker ikke om penge. Har lavet mine fejl, men jeg er jo bare et menneske.
Jeg er ikke perfekt, men jeg har det godt.
Flækker den tilfældig knæk din tidlige alarm. Lad knæk din tidlige alarm. Bare fordi jeg ville have respekt din.
so we gon' get the party jumping.
Counting my bullets, I'm loading my clips, I'm writing down names, I'm making a list, I'm checking it twice and I'm getting them hit. The real ones been dying, the fake ones is lit, the game is off balance, I'm back on my
first two intervals were great, crushed them, did a hit 405 or above, and then 420 something, and then same with the second one, about the same. Third one I just barely hit. Fourth one felt awful from probably a minute 30 in to that 3 minuter, and the last, it's funny, the first 90 seconds I thought I got this, no problem. And then just fatigue really bit hard there. And I think I got 400 on the dot. At least I did from my watch. It was 400 on the dot. I don't know what Zwift, it depends like where we started and stopped. Sometimes I'll start my watch like 1 second into their 3 minute and end up ending like a second after. I just go by the 3 minute on my watch in the end, because that's where I'm looking at the average. I do wish Zwift had a feature for workouts where you can see average wattages for the intervals. That'd be really handy, I think. $1 million idea right there, if Zwift's listening. Regardless, that's 18 minutes over 400 watts across only 8 intervals. That's pretty good. That's about 6 minutes at 420 and 12 minutes at about probably 402, 403 average. I'm not gonna call the workout a screaming success because it hurt like hell. And I mean, it was supposed to hurt like hell, so I mean, maybe it was. So, and then like I said, I did 2 times 15 seconds at the end. And that was really, I wasn't really concerned about the average power there. I didn't really expect after doing, like I said, 18 minutes of VO2 max work, I didn't expect to average 680 for 15 seconds. I mean, really all I was looking at was peak, and all I wanted to do was have a peak of 680. Ended up peaking at 675 on the second one. I still gotta work on my gearing on the sprints. I can't seem to quite get it, and maybe that'll help when I move off the wheel on trainer and move to the direct drive. But right now I just feel like I'm either too easy and like 8 seconds in I'm spinning out, or it takes me 10 seconds to wind it up. So still gotta work on that, because if I'm gonna be really dangerous and an all-rounder in these Zwift races, I gotta develop at least a tiny sprint at least have some ability in that. I'm not gonna spend hours developing a sprint, I'll say that, but just here or there, like 2 times 15 seconds, that's a good little set. Anyways, thanks so much for watching me suffer here. I might cool down a little bit longer, I feel like I need it. And then I'm gonna do just some core, just to round out the day. Like, share, subscribe, really appreciate it. And I'll see you tomorrow, as usual, at 4 p.m.